everything.
Everything.
You're everything to me.
Everything. To
everything. Everything to me.
Everything to me.
Everything.
Every day.
You're everything to me.
Everything to me.
Come on and celebrate Jesus in this place. Come on and lift up the matchless name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Music ministry and all that they're doing. Come on, let's celebrate God for them. And right before we pray for the man of God that's going to deliver the word, we want to again give our sincere thanks to the team at 104.1. Brother Abu, who came today, let's bless God for him. Come on, let's bless God for him. Our marketing team there at 104.1, Sister Cassandra and Sister Bobby. And what we want to do is we want to bless this young man with some gifts. Amen. For his heart. Y'all come on, celebrate God for my brother. Abu, hold on. And take that back to Cassandra and Bobby and let them know we appreciate them letting you come fellowship with us. Y'all come on, celebrate this young man. He teaches eighth grade. Amen. So all of our black men are not in jail, but there are some doing a great work in the Lord. Come on, celebrate God. Thank you, man. So much for your service to the kingdom. Amen. Thank you. Amen. We had to hunt him down. He ran out of here quick. Amen. But thank you so much and safe travels on your way back to Maryland. Amen. God bless you. Amen. So it's that time of preaching. It's that time of sharing. And we thank God for the man of God that has come to share the word of God. And so we'd ask that right there where you are, you begin to bow your head and begin to pray. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you, God, for your strength. We thank you, God, for the power that you're going to unveil in your servant today. Touch, God, his heart, touch his mind, touch his lips, that the word he delivers will be exactly what you sent for us. And we're going to glorify you. We're going to bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, stand to your feet, celebrate God for his word.
You may find your way to 1 Samuel. Chapter number 30. Is my intent not to be before you long, but just long enough to give you what the Lord has placed on my heart. 1 Samuel chapter number 30, we want to begin reading at verse number 6. David was greatly distressed because the men were talking of stoning him. Each one was bitter in spirit because of his sons and daughters. But David found strength in the Lord his God. Some text says he encouraged himself in the Lord. Then David said to Abiathar, the priest, the son of Ahimelech, bring me the ephod. Abiathar brought to him, and David inquired of the Lord, shall I pursue this raiding party? Will I overtake them? Pursue them, he answered. you will certainly overtake them and succeed in rescue. Some interpretation says, recover all. You may be seated. It is my prayer that the people of God learn to live bold in Him. It is my prayer that the people of God would not allow themselves to be bound up by the enemy, where there are no earthly good to themselves of others. It is my prayer that the people of God will be saved, that we will learn the power and the authority that God has given unto us, that the enemy has no choice but to get under our feet. We know that life can be difficult. So I am charged today to encourage you to keep it moving. Keep it moving. Have you ever been in a position that you wonder what's next? I'm preaching to those who know what it means to be in a storm. Talking to those who know what it means to fight the good fight of faith. I'm speaking to all of us. Perhaps life had brought you to a place where you were experiencing one problem after another. Like in the life of Job, one horrible report followed by another horrible report. Perhaps you may have come to a dead end, and you do not know what to do, like the children of Israel on a journey to the promised land, where they had the sea in front of them, mountains on each side, and the enemy in close pursuit, seeking to make them captives again. Seemingly, they had nowhere to go. It may be your experience, like in the life of David, when he and his men were out fighting and the Amalekites came in while they were away, took their wives and the children and burned the city, and then went off to have a good time over the loot that the enemy had stolen. I don't know about you, but when I found myself in places like that, I asked myself, what do you do when you're hard pressed on every side? Where do you go when you have trouble everywhere? I would suggest to you, keep it moving. I would suggest to you to keep it moving mentally, spiritually, and physically, that you and I might recover all. We know life can be brutal. Can I just get one amen? Amen. Issues and problems are no stranger to us. Misery has confronted us and sorrow has challenged us, yet we're still here. Hardship has visited us many times in hopes of paralyzing us, afflicting and leaving affliction behind. But by the grace of God, we still here. The question can be asked, how did we make it? I would suggest to you, without giving much thought, we kept it moving. We kept moving in God, moving in His power of His word, moving by the aid of the Holy Spirit, moving mentally in our minds, moving spiritually in our souls and with the Spirit. Keep moving physically that we might obtain what God has for us. We have scars to prove we have fallen. Pain is evidence that we have been in a fight. We got a limp to remind us we've been wrestling and would not give up. Do I have any witnesses in the house? But I'm charged to remind you and remind me this morning, no matter what life brings our way, keep it moving. The Lord has brought us this far, and he will lead us on. We have been challenged down through the months, down through the years, and many has grown weary. Many has given up. Many has turned their backs on God. Many forgot who brought them this far. And thus, we find ourselves like in the text. When the enemy comes in like a flood, you may wonder what's next. In the text, we find David, a man of God. He is troubled and he is full of sorrow, along with others in his command. David, the man chosen by God to be king, David, who sought the Lord early, David, who was after God's heart, David, the king, David has problems. I just want to touch on that, because if you think you're exempt from problems because of who you are, just keep living. So what we can learn from the text, if we have not experienced any problem in our lives, some things that may help us to achieve and be better in the days to come. I wish you didn't have your mask on, that you could tell the person next to you, keep it moving. David, and those who he was leading has returned from battle. They was out doing the Lord's work. While they were away, their home, their residence was raided. The children and their wives were taken away. They are tired from the fighting that they had prior to returning home. They are weary, and now they find themselves with anger that their enemy has come in and destroyed where they lived and taken their children and their wives. The families were taken, the homes were burned, and they agreed, and they were so upset, they wanted to kill their leader. Before you kill your leader, I just want you to keep it moving. What do you do when you cry and you have no more tears to shed? What do you do when you have no more power to weep? What do you do when you are greatly distressed and disturbed and you are in grief? I would suggest to you, keep it moving. Job would suggest to you, when he rent his mantle, shaved his head, fell upon the ground, and he worshiped. He said, naked came I from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return. The Lord gave, and the Lord shall take away. But what I want you to know, blessed be the name of the Lord. I would suggest we need to do like Job, and we need to do like David. Keep it moving mentally. Keep it moving spiritually, that we might have the physical strength to recover all that God has blessed us to have. Move spiritually. We must build ourselves upon the most holy faith. We can't allow sorrow to stop us from being who we are in Christ Jesus. After you cry, gird up the loins of your mind. Remind yourself that you are the chosen generation, royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own special people. Do I have any witnesses in the house? You ought to shout to the top of your voice, I am somebody. And I dare the enemy come in and take from me what God has blessed me with. I got to keep myself mentally. I got to keep myself spiritually, that I might pursue and get back what God has blessed me with. We are more than conquerors through him who loves us. We are the righteousness of God. And we cannot sit back and whine and cry because the enemy came in and tied us up. That's what he wants us to do. We want to rejoice and be exceedingly glad and seek God's face and go after what the enemy has taken. The scripture gives us some things that might help us to be encouraged as we go along life way. The scripture report, number one, that David encouraged himself in the Lord. How do you do that when you lost your family? How do you do that when your stuff is burned? How do you do that when you're tired and you came from the battlefield? How do you encourage yourself in the Lord? encourage means to push. It means to support. It means to aid. David strengthened himself in the Lord. David found strength in the Lord. Lord, where were you when I was off doing your business in my home? Where were you, God? That's where our minds go. But David found strength in the Lord. The text does not tell us how David encouraged himself. But I would imagine he struck up a tune in his heart since he was a worshiper. I would suggest you through the summit begin to remind himself of all that God has done and put it to a tune that he might encourage himself in the Lord. I would suggest to you that the worshiper begin to sing in a melody in his heart that he could get his strength back. God got this. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. I don't know. The text doesn't say, but if I were David, I would probably begin to remind myself, the Lord is my refuge and my strength. The very present help in the time of trouble. The Lord will fight my battle if I just keep still. Be merciful unto me, O God. Hear my cry. Hear my plea, O God. I seek your face. Have mercy upon me. I don't know what he said or to the Lord, but all I know is he carries himself in the Lord, and the word is the Lord. If the Lord can speak it, it shall happen. When I cry out to you, God, hear my prayer. Give attention to what I'm saying. I can imagine he called out from Psalms 37. I can't fret myself over evildoers. Neither should I be troubled over the workers of iniquity. I put my trust in the Lord. I will delight in the Lord of my salvation. I will commit my way to the Lord. The Lord orders the steps of the righteous. I don't know what David did to encourage himself, but I would imagine he used the word of the Lord. I must seek the Lord while he may be found and call upon him while he's near. What do you do when your heart is overwhelmed? What do you do when you lost what you worked hard for? What do you do when the enemy comes in like a flood? I pray that you will keep it moving. The Lord is the light of my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? That's Psalms 27. The second thing David did, he called the priest and said, hey, bring me the garment. Because it's time for me to talk to the Lord about this. What do we do? Do we take off on our own, trying to overtake the enemy in our own might? Or do we want to check in with God and see what God got to say about the situation? He said, bring me the ephod. It is that sacred garment worn by priests. Notice it's a garment worn by priests. But the king said, bring it to me. I don't have no time to be going through you. I need to talk to the Lord myself and get an answer for what I need to do in this situation. Oh, I know I'm coming down your street. You need to tell yourself, I need to see God about some things that's going on in my life. So he adorned this precious garment and he sought the Lord. And this is what he did. He inquired of God. He talked to God about his situation. Notice David inquired of the Lord. He went directly to the Lord himself. David asked God. Martha, he is so encouraged, he didn't ask God to give him strength. He didn't ask God anything but, can I go and will I overtake? That's all I want to know. I'm so happy right now in the power and the authority you've given me. All I need is your approval. Can I go? That's encouragement that God bless you so much when you done lost everything that you encourage yourself in the Lord that you just go to God for two things. Can I go and will I overtake? Because if I overtake, I'm going to get back everything you gave to me. All I need is your permission to leave from where I am to pursue the enemy that brought pain in my life. Shall I pursue after this truth? Shall I overtake him? The Lord said, pursue, and surely you'll overtake them. And on all of that, without fail, you're going to recover.
Not some of it. All of it. How many of you ready to go get some stuff that your enemy has taken from you? So before you strike out on your own, encourage yourself in the Lord. Before you strike out on your own, get God permission and ask them, are you going to be successful on the journey? That was just added bonus when God said, pursue and you shall overtake, and without fail, you're going to get it back. That right there ought to put so much joy in us, so much enthusiasm, so much encouragement that God approved. The Lord told David, pursue and you shall surely overtake them, and without fail, you won't recover at all. So David pursued. I wonder how many of us, when we get an answer, we're going to sing God. We're going to dispatch an angel when he has already given authority and the power for us to go forward. So David pursued with 600 men. After he cried, after he called out, after he got permission, he got up and he went after. So for those of us in here today, I plead unto you to inquire of the Lord. Get strength from God that you can go do the impossible. It's going to be a challenge, because as David went with 600, two hundred of them got so tired they couldn't go any further. It would look like God is dwindling it down. God just trying to show you, I'm going to see if you're going to trust me. I'm going to see if you're going to keep doing what you asked me could you do. Some of us will stop because it looked like we can't do it with the few numbers that we have now. But after David inquired, he pursued and he recovered all. I would suggest when we are overcome with problems and issues beyond us, we need to keep it moving. Keep it moving. I said keep it moving mentally. See, what happens when problems and issues coming our way, we begin to think that it's all over. We begin to think that ain't nothing can happen now. We begin to whine and cry and get ourselves down in a stupor. But what we need to do is get our minds together. We need to set our affections on things above. Remind ourselves that we are somebody in Christ. And by his stripes, we are already healed. And we got to get up and be about our Father's business. Get your minds together. Set your affection on things above. Think and dwell on the things of God and not on the things that are around you. Get your thoughts together. Get your thinking together. Get your mind together. Know what you're going to ask God for. Get so encouraged in your prayer and worship time that you can ask God, can I go after him? I'm so excited right now. I know I can overtake him. I know I can get it. I just need your permission. Can I go? So he got himself together mentally. Getting himself together mentally, he used the spiritual things of God to give him that strength. So keep it moving mentally. Don't fall prey to your mind, your thought. And don't let your thought overwhelm you that you become weak and no good spiritually. There's a power, a force that God give us called the Holy Spirit that would gird us up and lead and empower us to do what no man can do unto us. So he got himself together mentally, he got himself together spiritually, and with that his little old body could move according to the ways of God. And he went forth and he overtook them and took away everything that was taken, took back everything that was taken away from him. He recovered, not just his family, not just his property. Stay with me. He got back everything. Y'all not feeling me. Y'all like standing there. Yeah. He got his wife back. He got his children back. He got every animal and cow and whatever. He got it all back, but it ain't all he got back. Well, you just punch your neighbor and say he got his joy back. Tell your neighbor he got his leadership back. The same people that wanted stoned him is now rejoicing with him because he got it all. Yeah. Tell tell your neighbor, I'm going to get my stuff back. I'm going to get my joy back. I'm going to get my peace back. I'm going to get my family back. I'm going to get my property back. I'm going to get my tune back. I'm going to get back everything that the enemy thought he took from me. He got it all back, but the silent enemy didn't want it to rest there. That 200 that couldn't make it, didn't have the strength. When the 400 and David got back with everything, the ones that went to battle, no, we ain't going to share with them. David is so joyous and said, the devil is a lie. God gave us favor. And because he blessed us, we going to share. Because we in this together. Can you imagine us being victorious and coming back and the people that's in our camp, we don't want to share the glory of God? Oh no, you're going to get your little bit. We want everybody to be exceedingly glad and happy in what the Lord has done. So I just want you to know, my brother and sister, when we press towards the mark of the high calling of God, God will remind us that he's on our side. When we are hard pressed on every side, and we feel like we're alone, we got doubt raising in us, we need to begin to ask ourselves and tell ourselves, keep it moving. Keep your mind moving in Christ. Keep your mind stayed on him. Keep moving spiritually that your little old body can do what the mind of God is telling you to do. Don't lose heart. Though the outward man's perish, the inward man is renewed day by day. That which is working on the outside trying to destroy us. But God says, I'll create in you a fountain of living water that will never run dry. So we need to remind ourselves, get our eyes off the problem and get our eyes on our Savior. Fix your eyes on Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Keep moving in God. Don't stop. Don't quit. Don't give up. Keep moving. Keep moving in faith. If we keep moving, we're going to move out of it. Y'all didn't get it. If you keep moving, you're going to move into it. But if you stop and whine, you'll never get it. So what's next in our life? I don't know. But if I keep moving, I'm going to find out. Oh, y'all don't hear me. What's coming up around the corner? I don't know. But if I keep moving, I'm going to find out. Matter of fact, I'm going to walk up on what's next, and what's next going to walk up on me if I keep moving. And all I'm trying to encourage the body of Christ here this morning is keep it moving mentally, keep it moving spiritually, keep your body moving in God. And you will recover all. Walk it out. Walk into it. Make it happen. Because you sought God about it and he given you permission about it. Walk it out. Keep it moving and the snakes will find you. When our adversary seeks to stop us, we must be strong and mighty in the Lord and in his power. We must continue to walk by faith and not sight. Yeah, I know you're trying to disturb me with that, but there is something beyond this little problem. And I'm going to move through it, over it, and in it to get back what God has forgiven unto me. The scripture says in Psalm 37:23, the steps. Step means you're picking up one foot. You never have both foot off the ground at the same time. You're picking up one foot, planting and then planting the other. That means you are moving. That means you are making progress. The steps of a good man, of a righteous man, of a righteous person, they are ordered by the Lord. So if I'm at this place in my life, he must have ordered me here. And if he ordered me here, I should have enough mind, he gonna carry me all the way. Can I get a witness in the house? If the Lord ordered, well, let me back up. Are you righteous in God? Are you a believer in God? Have God sanctified you and glorified you and predestined you? Well, he orders your step. You thought you made the wrong turn, but God knew that he needed to lead you this way, that you might put your trust in him, that you might inquire of him. The Don't worry about when the wicked and evil come in to do wrong. They shall soon fade away. Trust in the Lord and do good. Feed upon the faithfulness of God. Delight yourself also in him, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Do you want what you lost so bad that you are willing to ask God about it? Are you tired of losing? You want to be a winner for a change? Have you inquired and asked God about it? When life becomes difficult, we must not forget the word of God. We cannot abort the word of God. We should not forsake the word of God when life becomes hard. The word of God is the power of God to remind us, to give us that strength, to encourage us. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. So when we distance ourselves from God, we become weak. So we need to draw nigh unto him that he might draw nigh unto us. And we will know what he wants us to do. We need to bind mercy and truth around our necks. Write them up on the tables of our heart. And trust God with all of our heart. And lean not to our own understanding. But in all our ways, acknowledge him. And he shall strengthen our path. The Lord said he would never leave us nor forsake us. Touch your neighbor and say, start reminding yourself of that. When you start losing, God just making room for you to get more. When you get weak, God is just trying to remind you or remind us that by his stripes we're healed and he give us strength. When it looked like you had a dead end street, my suggestion, just start looking around, because he will make a way of escape. Just because it looked bad in the eyes of the natural, there's something going on in the heavenly that God is working things out for our behalf. I'm just trying to encourage you. If you're on the mountaintop right now and all is well, you need to put this in your hip pocket, because something is coming your way. You might be in a storm right now. I'm just trying to encourage you to encourage yourself in the Lord. Inquire of him. And if you're coming out of a storm, don't lose hope. Another one is coming, and you need the power of God to get through it. So I submit to you, keep it moving. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. The enemy may want to stop you. Keep it moving. The enemy wants you to be distracted and discouraged. Keep it moves. I am not going to get discouraged over this. I am not going to get bothered over this. Matter of fact, we have gone through far worse than we are experiencing in our lives right now. And we should not let these light and momentary affliction keep us from doing the thing that God called us to do. I ain't begging nobody come back to the Lord. Oh no, I'm going to rejoice and be exceedingly glad. I'm going to go on and see what the end going to be. I'm going to tell you. But I ain't going to fight with you. Anybody that want God going to go after God. And I know what God will do. God will bless us beyond. He will blow our mind. And we will put our trust in him. So wherever you are in life, keep it moving. Keep it moving. Whatever's going on in your life, keep it moving. Whatever's coming your way that's making you sad, keep it moving. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. People talk bad about you. Tell your neighbor, forget those things. I mean, can I help somebody? Forget those things where? Say that real loud. Forget those things that are. Okay. But if you keep it out in front of you, tell your neighbor, put it behind you and forget it. Walk on by it. God gonna bring something greater to pass. Put it. The enemy has not the power that you allow him to have. So let us press towards the mark of the high call of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. This simple little message about a king who lost everything is teaching us that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. This king, man after God's own heart, is reminding us, no matter who you are, problems can come your way. But our answer is in God. So don't fret no more. Encourage yourself. Strengthen yourself. Gain strength from God. Get in his word. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. Anything I ask of the Lord, believing it shall be done. I'm going to gird myself up with some word. Now I'm strong. It'd be crazy for me to go ask God when I'm weak, can I go after them? Now I got my right mind. Now I know I can take it. Now I know I can get it back. I just want permission, God. Can I go? Because when I get there, I'm going to get it back. I just keep it moving. Notice now he kept it moving in his mind. He didn't not allow his problem to get him despondent. After he cried and he didn't have no more tears, he realized, I need to talk to the Lord about this. After he encouraged himself, he got strong and mighty. Bring me the ephod. Lord, I got two things for you. Can I go? And will I overtake? And I'm showing you right now, God, I heard you say go. And you will recover all. I would suggest to you, don't strike out by yourself. You need some help. The same one that you talk with to walk with you. So I pray that bless somebody today. That we need to fight the good fight of faith. Faith come by hearing. Hearing the word of God. Let God stand up in you and me. Let us join hand. And let the enemy know you don't come up in the place where we live and cause yourself doing damage. We will chase you down until we find you. There's so much, I pray you will read it. As they pursued, they ran across a young slave, an Egyptian who was slave of one of the Amalekites, that his master thought no more of him than to leave him to die because he got sick. David was so encouraging God that he gave the young man water and food, strengthened him. Who are you and who do you belong to? I'm just a slave of one of the Amalekites. 3 days ago, I fell sick. He dropped me off. Can you show us where he live? If you promise me you won't turn me over, I won't live with that family no more. David says, I promise. And who was an enemy led him further into where the enemy were. And this ought to make somebody mad. The enemy is now laying around having a good time on your stuff. But he recovered it. He recovered it. And that's what God wants us to know today. Despite what COVID has done, despite what people are saying, you inquire of me. And I'll show you how to get it back. You inquire of me, and I will strengthen you. I will make you so happy in me, you be excited about going and taking your stuff back. So I'm speaking to all those at home. You sheltered in. You're scared to come out. Renew your mind. Speaking to those of us in here who are just petrified on all this going on around the world. Let's focus. Gain some strength. Aren't you tired of being tired? You have to do that. And I know you will. Put your hands together and bless God. Put your hands together and bless God. Put your hands together and bless God. He is able, church, but do you trust him? He is able. Will you put your trust in him? Wherever you are, the Lord knows. And apparently, he brought us to where we are.
And now he wants us to focus our attention on him. Pastor Tremaine, I'm going to ask you to come and open. Give those who are listening an opportunity to reconsider and think about who God is in their lives. I'm not talking about membership right now. I'm talking about your relationship with the one who is able. We love you. We're going to get back stuff that caused us to cry. We're going to take back the stuff that brought us down to despair. We're going to get back what it's taken for us. How do I know that? Somebody shout, we're going to keep it moving.
Right where you are, Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for the heart that you spoke to. We thank you for the mind that's going to make a decision today to strengthen their relationship with you. Let us not be so motivated that we do not take action with our faith. So God, now whoever is in the midst and who's online, we're beginning to touch and agree all over the sanctuary that your will be done in their life. As the choir ministers and sings the melodies of Zion, that God, the beast inside of us will submit. Submit not to the melody, but submit to the one in whom has power. So God, remind us again in this moment of who we are and who you are. It's in Jesus' name we pray. If you're in here, if you're joining us online, and you want to make that decision that I want to connect closer with God, this is this moment that we set aside that many would call the highlight of worship. The moment when we give individuals that opportunity to come into relationship with God. So the first call is for those that don't know him in the pardon of their sins. Those that do are going to begin to pray right now in your own way that person that needs salvation, that they'll hear God. If you feel God pushing and God urging you to give your life to him, I want you just simply to raise your hand. Nobody's going to judge you, but we're going to love on you. The second call goes for those that recognize that maybe along the way you've not been in the fellowship you should be with God. And today you realize that you got to keep it moving. You can't waste time anymore where you were. But you have to focus on where God is going to take you. And so we're all praying together that if that's you, whether online, whether in the sanctuary, just simply raise your hand. So if you know your soul is secure, you know where your relationship stands. I want you to stand to your feet, give God a praise for what he's doing in your life. Okay, let me try it again. If you are secure, there were two calls, one's for those that did not know him and one's for those that needed a relationship that was stronger. That means if you didn't raise your hand for either one of those, you're secure. I want the secure people of God to begin to praise God right now for what he's doing in your life. That's kind of weak for secure people. Do me a favor, just right behind your mask, just look to the person to your left and your right and ask them, are you secure? Now when they asked you, I want you to answer. Look at them and say, are you secure? Do you know where your name is? Now if they said yes and you said yes, I want you to put your hands together and praise your God. It said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. If you're redeemed, you should not have a problem giving God his praise that he is worthy of. As you take your seat, this is when we observe what we call our Holy Communion. There are those a part of our leadership team that are going to come now and begin to serve and begin to share the broken bread, which represents the broken body, the cup, which represents the shed blood. And if you're online, we want to give you an opportunity. You don't have to be fancy, but secure something, some juice, some water, piece of bread, a cracker, even a potato chip will suffice. And the reason is because this is the moment that represents the symbolicness of what Christ did for us. And so we use this moment that we can reflect, that we can remember how God entered our life and what he did for us, that he shed his blood, that he took beatings and bruisings, that for all the mess ups I would do, I could be forgiven. And as they're passing out those elements, as you're securing them online, take a moment and reflect of who God is to you. Those elements, we're going to ask you to stand to your feet.
Oh, Jesus, you're everything.
Father, bless these elements. That which represents your body, that which represents your blood. And that God, we not take it lightly. But God, even as we peel the plastic and the foil back, that we'll stop and examine ourselves. If there's anything we know, God, that's not in order with you, that right now in this moment we'll ask forgiveness. That we do not take your communion in a moment of sin. So God, we search our own hearts, we search our own minds, and we say thank you, God, for forgiving us. Not just for our past sins, but our present and our future sins. Take us, God, in this sacred moment. And connect us with you. That as we commune, our mind will remember who you are. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Let everybody say amen. Let us commune first the bread. Now the cup. And we're going to ask you to hold on to that. You don't have to collect them. Hold on to that. Because see, sometimes we need a memory. And sometimes we move so fast in what we're doing that we forget that there's reasons why we do things. So I want you to hold on to that. Take it home. Take it with you this week. That when you slip, stumble, and fall, because you will, that you can remember the price was paid. Would you do that for me? Come on, celebrate God. Come on, celebrate him. As we prepare to lift up our offerings.
You're everything. Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Everything to me. Oh, Jesus.
We want you to get your offering.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
You're everything.
Everything to me.
Jesus.
whether you gave online or whether you're giving in the traditional format, we want you to come and bless God today. If you gave online, just bring your instrument that you gave with and just touch the basket. We're going to pray first and then we're going to give some simple instructions, okay? Father, we thank you for the gifts that we're giving. We thank you for the heart and the mind in which we give. So God, now bless us that as we shall give, you will see our heart. You will see our desire to please you. You will see our desire to sacrifice to you. So God, bless your giver. In Jesus' name we pray. Let everybody say amen. As we're all standing, listen now, listen. As we're all standing, we're going to ask everybody on my left to come and give your offering. Everybody on my left, come and give your offering. Just come on, bring it. Just come on and bring it. Those on the right, you should already be getting excited because you get the opportunity to give next.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Come on, choir.
Jesus.
Yeah, you're everything. Yeah,
everything to me.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Yeah, you're everything. You're everything
to me.
Come on,
Jesus.
On the right side. Come on and give.
Yeah, Jesus.
Jesus.
You're everything. You're
everything to me.
Water when I'm thirsty.
Jesus.
Food when I'm hungry.
Jesus.
Yeah, you're everything. You're everything to me. Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Yeah, you're everything. You're everything to me. You're my healer, Jesus. You're my healer. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, yes, you are. You're
everything to me.
Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
Amen.
Say, oh Jesus, you're everything, you're everything, you're
everything to
Jesus. Yeah, Jesus. Yeah, Jesus. Yeah, Jesus. Yeah, Jesus. Everything to me. Troubled waters, Jesus,
oh Jesus, you're everything to me.
Come on, give God a praise for what he's done in our lives today. We're ready to go. We pray that today has been enriching, has been encouraging, but most important, it's been stimulating, that all of us can take action to what God is speaking to all of us. Amen. I'm going to ask our music ministry, amen, to get something upbeat. Y'all look like the world has come to an end. Am I right, praise team? They looking like, Lord Jesus, amen. Look at your neighbor, say, God is still on the throne. Lord, have mercy. We going out on a high note. Amen. As you leave out of the fellowship hall, make sure you stop by, amen, on November the 12th. We're having a blood drive. There are people that are in need of blood, amen. And I just believe not only the blood of Jesus, but the blood in you, amen, can help somebody else's life. So I pray you'll see Minister Fort, amen, in the vestibule and sign up for a time slot, amen, that you may be able to give blood on November the 13th, whatever that Saturday is, the 13th, I believe it is. Is that right, the 13th? 12th, all right, thank you. November the 12th, Saturday, November the 12th, see him in the vestibule that you can be able to sign up. Ladies, where my ladies at? All the single ladies, come on, where the ladies at? Amen, the women are going to be having a women's tea on October the 15th. Amen, men, look at the women. Is that right? Look at the women and say, there's a tea for you. All you got to do is just see Deacon Ann Black or Sister Tanya in, I believe, in the Vine Bookstore, and they want you to sign up just so they can account for you so you can come for high tea. I was saddened to hear about the death of the print queen, and I never got a chance to have high tea with her. But I understand it is an experience, and I believe the women of destiny are going to have an experience of high tea. Amen on October the 15th, but it takes all of you. Amen. I guess we have low tea. Amen. I guess we have low tea. Amen. To all of our new members, thank you so much for being a part of our new members session today. Every Sunday at 9 a.m. downstairs in the classroom, we have new members orientation. If you have not had a new members orientation, or you just want to be refreshed, come on downstairs to be a part of that. And don't forget, new generation, amen, they are busting loose. They are downstairs today, every Sunday after the day. So come on and join us as we live this place. Let's stand and get ready to go.
Yes, sir.
Deep down in my heart,
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
Deep down in my heart,
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus. Deep down in my heart.
Everybody say deep, deep, down, down.
Deep down in my heart.
Yeah, deep,
deep.
Blessed for a great week in the Lord. Amen. We're going out
of
the
kind of
I love you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Deep down in my heart.
I love you, Jesus.
Have a great week.
Yeah, yeah.
Deep down in my heart.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
Deep down in my heart.
Here we go. Say deep, deep, down, down.
Deep down in my heart.